And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity, The White March, Part 1. I'm the RPG Chick, and we're heading into the inn known as the Grave's Rest. Hello, hello. A bard.
Got it. I dread discovering what passes for cuisine in this place.
Can't interact, huh? This character is currently busy. Got a joke for us? This place could use some merriment. Never turn your back on the battery. Walk backwards and pray to Abaddon. There's a kid here. Papa says I'm not allowed to play with the other kids because we got in trouble.
Ooh. Still can't feel my fingers.
Feara. Said that. Got a joke for us, blah blah blah. Villager. Place wouldn't be the same without Katie. Good on you for saving her. Let's just look around a little more before we talk to Feara. Careful, if you're new. The drinks here aren't watered down. Good thing Hafrick still has some venison in stock. Hardly any elk left. Theirs is still going on about that beast he's after. He should focus on ogres. I hear Defiance Bay got hit pretty hard by the legacy. Wonder if it's as bad as we got. Oh, is that Katie? He's a cook. Move along, move along. No pilfering from the ovens. Actually, I was just trying to talk to you, but whatever. I can keep their rice. He used to, hick, surviving another day in this frozen pit. Is Hafrick?
Owena! Go check on that Orlin. Make sure he don't steal nothing.
The ogres have been hitting us hard, trying to keep us out of the battery. And they're winning. Hardly anyone coming up the roads these days. You're the first new face in weeks. If you hear voices around the battery, trace Andra's wave over your heart. Interesting idea. Well, we got a bunch of people to talk to. Let's talk to Hafrick first, though. Yeah, pretty much.
Never seen such a bloodbath. Feels like we got half the town's survivors in here just drinking to forget it.
The dwarf surveys the crowd, his expression sober despite the half-empty flagon by his hand. He shakes his head and looks to you, remembering himself.
But you must be looking for some refreshment, too, after the way you handle them ogres. Or perhaps a room. Say the word and I'll give that shifty little Orlin the boot.
He nods at you with gruff camaraderie. Oh, well, we completely snitch on Rayfaw there. What Orlin?
Showed up a few days ago, sticks his nose out of the back room just long enough to empty his chamber pot.
He squints toward the hall as if daring the Orlin to show himself.
Up to no good, I tell you. I'd like nothing more than to see him gone, but I don't want a ruckus over it.
What makes you so sure he's trouble?
We get our share of lowlifes coming through here. Smugglers, fugitives, kith looking to avoid the sharp eye of the law. Way he's keeping to himself. Well, honest Kith sure don't have cause for it.
I could talk to him.
Don't hurt him or anything. I just want him to leave peacefully. Given your history, I thought I'd be clear on that point.
He gives you a meaningful look. I'd laugh if that was... Yeah, we're laughing.
Back to warm your hands, eh? What can I do for you?
We haven't stopped talking yet. See what refreshments you've got. Aeloth leans in and whispers, Are you sure, Theodas? I think I saw a fish head floating in the stew pot. That's for flavoring, Aeloth.
Nothing like a pint to take the chill off.
Stalwart rabbit stew. plus 0.05 move speed and plus 2 perception for 150 seconds. Stalwart locals have their own common stew recipe that relies on marinated rabbit meat, onions, wine, and vinegar. Due to Stalwart's remote location, they don't use exotic spices for flavoring, only what they grow locally and dry during the summer months. White Inifer. Plus 3 damage reduction for 120 seconds. Made with juniper berries that are common in the foothills and low slopes of the White March, White Inifer is popular with locals as well as northern neighbors in Red Saras. It is normally distilled in simple household pots with grain mash and various local herbs to meet the maker's preferences. Because it is a powerful spirit, it is not popular as a recreational drink in Ir Glamfath. Speckleback jerky? Oh, yeah. Did we see this before? Not sure. Yeah, we have seen it. Yeah, I've seen it. Potion of Flame Shield. I got camping supplies. Take some lockpicks. Why not? Will you buy crap from me? Will you buy this? So Hafrick, the innkeeper of the Grave's Rest, thinks there's something suspicious about one of his guests. According to him, the Orland staying in one of the rooms has been behaving strangely, and he would like someone to get to the bottom of things. He showed up a few days ago, has been hiding out in one of the rooms. He would like me to get rid of him, but doesn't want me to hurt him. Is the bard still busy? Is it true they set fire to Defiance Bay? Dear, we're just gone mad. Alright. That's all we had to look forward to? Let's talk to this Feara.
Thought I'd found shelter when I stumbled across this little village. Guessing you did too, huh?
Feara raises a frosty mug to you. Even though the warmth of the hearth reaches you here, her hands are wrapped in weir wool and her ears muffled by a hat. Her face has the taut, wind-beaten look of someone who's recently come from the road.
As much blood as there was in the streets, I'm lucky the ale's still flowing.
She takes a drink, and as she tilts her head back, you see a bruise purpling her jaw and the crimson bloom of scraped knuckles. What exactly happened to you?
Thought all the whispers about Durgan's battery were just village superstition. And maybe they are, but I might have been on my guard if I'd listened. I was part of an expedition, hunting for relics from Durgan's battery. And picked up a good haul, too.
She takes a slow swallow of her beer.
So it figures that's when the winds pick up and the sky starts dumping snow. We lost sight of the road. Meanwhile, something else found us.
Uh-oh.
Took Lena out before we even realized we were surrounded. And then we see him coming out of the snow. These little four-armed wilder. Lagufoth, they're called.
I heard it's pronounced Lagufoth. I gotta remember that. Lagufoth. She shakes her head, staring at the embers in the fire pit. Lagufoth. Okay, just think of the E as silent. As in a lot of things, they have silent vowels.
Quick, little bastards. Francesca and I held them off as long as we could, but when they filled her full of darts, I turned tail and ran.
Francesca, huh?
Found my way here and thanked my luck for escaping the Lagufoth. Then come to find out that this town's got an ogre problem.
She laughs bitterly. I didn't hear her laugh bitterly. I'm sorry to hear about your friends.
That's a kind sentiment. I'll mourn them when I get home. But I've got to retrieve our haul if I'm to have any hope of that. I need to get those artifacts. Not that I'm in any shape to go after them myself. but I can't afford to return to Defiance Bay without something to show for my expedition.
Apprehension creeps into her expression. She stares into her mug, swirling its contents.
But you've got your own expedition to the Battery, don't you? While you're out there, maybe you could look for my goods, whatever's left of them.
She looks up from her mug, hopeful.
I'll give you a cut for anything you bring back, of course. I ain't asking for charity. I just can't afford to go home empty-handed.
She brushes her nails along the side of her mug as that anxious look returns. Tell me what you're looking for.
Like I said, we were treasure hunting near Durgan's Battery when we were ambushed. What else do you want to know?
Huh. That's interesting. Examine her teeth. Renengill told me that another expedition came through before I arrived. Was that you?
Who?
She looks momentarily confused. Yeah, she doesn't know this place.
No, that would have been somebody else. We didn't meet with Renengill, or anyone else in town for that matter. We were operating on our own.
She looks into the fire pit, taking another drink. What do you know about Durgan's Battery?
Just that it's been locked up tight for 200 years on account of those dwarves having a row.
She shrugs.
Which means that any trinkets from inside fetch a nice price. Sorry, I'm more of a businesswoman than a historian.
We can examine her teeth. As Feara talks, you notice that her teeth and gum are stained with dark spots. That doesn't look good. The obvious answer would be they're expensive and rare and would fetch a good price. But why are these relics so important to you?
We took out several loans to pay for our trip out here. I'm gonna have trouble if I don't pay them back.
She scratches the back of her neck. The back of her neck, another, symptom of what's going on here? Remind me where I can find your caravan.
What's left of it should be near Durgan's Battery. If you stumble across the Logothoth, you'll know you're close.
Alright, goodbye. So she was traveling Scald. An expeditioner, she was attacked by Logothoth near Durgan's Battery. She lost her companions and their artifacts. She'd like the former avenged and the latter retrieved. Have to head that way to start looking for the remains of her expedition.
You find anything? Hate to think of those slimy bastards carrying my haul into a freezing hole somewhere.
She grimaces into her drink. Alright, who else? Who's this? Brithwin. Oh, they're throwing darts? You know what I'm liking? No more backer messages and no more long-ass stuff to read about people's history. We can actually interact with named NPCs. Alright, I know I clicked on the other guy, but Andred says, hey there, good timing. You can watch me Birthwin. Alcohol says, alcohol and sharp objects. This won't end well. Birthwin says once, Andred. You won once. What are you playing? Orlin's head. Andred grins sheepishly. That's what they call it anyhow. Birthwin says smooth. You pick a target, see? Nose or ears? Nose is worth more, but you've got two ears to work with. You get less points the further out from the target you get, so for the mouth and eyes, no points if you miss. Fancy a game? Three throws each, and whoever gets the most points by the end of it wins the wager. I'll put down 50 pens if you will. That's a little tasteless. Hey, I didn't name it. Don't take it so seriously. Not like we're using a real Orlin. Now, I wonder if we had Heravius with us, what he'd be saying right now. It'd be funny if he actually attacked them. Can you explain the targets again? Sure. I just got it memorized. Hick! Nose is worth 10 points. Mouth and eyes, 5. Ears are worth 7. Furs, 2. And bear skins, 1. Sure, why not? I'm going to hell. Oh my god. Andred pulls a throwing knife from his belt, turning it over in his hands. I'd feel better if it was an ogre face. Wages 50 pans. You in? Yeah, let's play. Lovely. I'll go first, just to show you how it's done. Andred aims carefully and throws his blade. The knife hits the fur, scoring 2. That's a cranium shot, though. Andred walks up to retrieve the knife. Your turn. And for the nose. The knife hits the mouth, scoring 5. Andred aims carefully and throws his blade. The knife hits the nose, scoring 10. Same for the ears this time. The knife hits the skin, scoring 1. Aim for an ear. The knife hits the eye, scoring 5. What the hell? That's 11 for you and 19 for me. This game's mine. The coin, too. Andret snickers. Come on back if you want to try again. That's alright. That's our ogre-slaying friend. Have they crowned you queen of Stalwart yet? Andred says. My friend doesn't mean to be an ass, ma'am. It just comes natural. What? I'd want a crown. I'll be going. Suit yourself. Let's talk to Katie.
Oh, it's you. I'm so glad you came by. I hoped I'd have the chance to thank you properly.
The voices, the volume of these voices, very, widely.
They told me what happened. God's bless you, ma'am. I owe you my life. I know it was foolish of me to run in there, but this ring is all that I have of my family.
I wasn't thinking. I guess she wasn't thinking of saying that. She talks very fast, too. It's interesting. How are you holding up? How are you holding up?
Oh, I'm managing. Fenway's letting me stay with her until I'm back on my feet. Everyone's been lovely, really. It was hard seeing what's left of the house. But Raywald says he's going to see a hut raised for me soon as they get the logs.
What's so special about this ring, anyway?
Sentiment, mostly. When he first settled here, my grandfather had a ring fashioned from the first batch of ore he excavated. It was supposed to commemorate his fresh start. He passed it on to his daughter, and my mother gave it to me in turn.
Hmm. Maybe you can help me. I'm looking for some Fenland liquor.
Funny. Raywald was just in here asking after the same thing. Guess that stuff really is popular.
Yeah, must have been just a coincidence. He's the one who sent us on the quest to find the Fenland liquor.
Averick has some, but he says the Fenland stuff's not for sale. And he's rigged up the cellar like a battlefield trying to keep people out.
Really?
Sorry. If anyone deserves a drink, it's you, ma'am. But I don't think I could convince him.
Huh. So don't tell him. Help me grab a bottle from the cellar.
Oh, I wouldn't get 2 feet past the steps. He's forever accusing me of sneaking sweets. Listen, Haverick showed me how one of the traps worked, so I wouldn't get too close if I had to pop down for supplies. I'm pretty sure I can disable it. Just give me a little time, and please don't get caught. I don't know how I'd explain all this. I'll have to sneak down when the cook's not looking.
Hmm. I wonder when that would be. This large piece of stone is adorned with an engraving of a hammer and chisel, though the writing beneath is too worn away to read. I think we've talked to everybody in this main room. More villagers. If I hear Havrick complain about that Orlan one more time, never turn your back on the battery. Walk backwards and pray to Abaddon. Closed door, open door. Is this the Orlan? That's Owina. Cape of Deflection. Ooh, plus 5, nice. A ring of searing flames and a scroll of binding web. Combusting wounds, 3 per rest.
Excuse me, was there something you need?
Owina jumps. She knits her fingers together and looks intently at the floor. I guess not. Farewell. She's just here to stop us from getting that cloak of deflection. I'm not sure if I'd use it anyway. I'd probably just sell it. Oh, it doesn't seem like there's anyone in here.
I shall be discreet.
40 gold? A rite of walking shadows. Plus 3 stealth for 120 seconds could be handy for that. What do you call it? Trap-ridden cellar. Maybe this Orlan's in here. Is his name Aleph?
Not to be rude, but I'm rather busy. Can't you get another room?